Wayland is here, and it's here to stay. But that doesn't mean that every single problem has been resolved. Some of the problems are still from Wayland's earliest days, where I don't understand how some of them are problems. Standard protocols for things that should have existed from the start, which still don't exist. Like window placement. Why is this so difficult? Why do people argue that no one wants it, that developers shouldn't have it, even though every single other system, except the mobile ones, because they do apps in a different way, everything else has a way to do window placement. Keyboard configuration. How is that not a standard protocol? I don't understand. I don't think anyone would even argue about that one. It's just, for some reason, not a standard. Now, some of the complaints are really dumb, but others, I do understand why they are common complaints. One of those things is Wayland session restoration. Personally, for me, not really that big of a deal. When I shut down my system, I close the windows. If my desktop crashes, frankly, I don't really care that much about it. I save things frequently, and I don't really have that many windows open where, you know, reloading back into things would be that big of a deal. But if you have a very complex setup, if you forget to save things, yeah, session restoration is incredibly useful. Now, this is not the first time I have talked about this topic. Back in, I believe, what is 5 months ago? October of last year, I did talk about Wayland session restoration, and this was mainly covering things happening over in GNOME, the implementation of XDG session management. This is the long-term solution, the Wayland session management protocol, where applications can communicate with everything that needs to go on, and things work. This is not the only solution that was going in place, though. KDE also had a solution being worked on, which they were referring to as fake session restoration, where it wasn't really restoring your session. It wasn't remembering what windows were open and what they had open. It was only doing that first part, remembering the windows you had open and then relying on the session restoration functionality built into these tools, right? If you're using a text editor, a video editor, a browser, a lot of other tools like this, they have a built-in way to do crash recovery. So you might as well just hook into that functionality and just make use of it because it gets you most of the way there. It's not perfect. There are some things where you can't really restore the session in that way, like a video player, for example. You won't remember what video was playing many cases or where in the video you were. But mostly there. It was fake, but fine. Now, for the record, this wasn't a situation where GNOME was doing something and then nobody else agreed to it. KDE also was working on the protocol as well. It's just they wanted something to be in place until the protocol was fully ready, until all of the pieces were in place to make this, you know, actually work properly. So yes, this is one of those rare cases where people agreed that this is a problem, and not only agreed that this is a problem, but agreed that a solution should be put in place that we all agree to and not spend 10 years trying to argue about it. Now, to be fair, this is one of those protocols that did start on the mailing list 7 years ago, but it wasn't being argued about. It's mainly like people weren't working on it, which not great for Wayland. It's kind of like how things normally go, but at least there wasn't like a 500 comment thread arguing about the existence of the protocol. For a variety of cases, it's desirable to have a method for negotiating the restoration of previously used states for a client's windows. This helps for e.g. a compositor slash client crashing, definitely not due to bugs, or a background client deciding to temporarily destroy its services in order to conserve resources. This protocol adds a method for managing session negotiation and is loosely based on the Enlightenment Session Recovery Protocol, which has been implemented and functional for roughly 2 years. This has been on the GitLab for about 5 years now, but like most things in Wayland, did start in the mailing list back when it actually was active and things were being done there, and a lot of the main development was coming from the main list back in 2018 by Mike Blumenkrantz. As it currently stands, the protocol has not been merged into Upstream Wayland yet. And the main reason for that, I don't know why this happens, by the way, I've never worked it out. The main reason why it's like that is it's still progressing and we're still waiting on implementations to go in place, because you can't just merge into Upstream Wayland and say, well, everything just works now. Upstream Wayland is just like a discussion space to implement the protocols. The protocols being implemented needs to be done in the desktops, needs to be done in the toolkits, in some cases, needs to be done in individual applications. I did mention both GNOME and KDE currently having implementations available. On the GNOME side, there is also an implementation over in the GNOME toolkit as well. There is also one over in Western, but things are still not entirely in place. I don't believe there's one in Qt yet, and there are some applications which are really complex and might not entirely use another toolkit that do need their own implementations done as well. One of the biggest is Chromium. And very recently, we saw this merged over in the Chromium repo. XDG session management, add Ozone/Wayland implementation. This CL adds the initial support for session management in the Ozone/Wayland based on the current experimental implementation shipped in Mudder since version 47 onwards. Because this hasn't been merged into Upstream Wayland yet and exists just as implementations in various projects like this, like GNOME, like KDE, like GTK, yes, it is still considered experimental. When it's merged into Upstream Wayland, that's when it becomes a lot harder to actually make changes from there. Remarkable implementation decisions. Session creation is exposed as a synchronous API, and if successful, the session ID is returned to the caller. That's basically because any window creation depends on session object information, as the window creation initialization is spread over several different layers. Having this as a synchronization API streamlines the whole process. Multiple simultaneous XDG sessions are supported. As of right now, Chrome Session Restore code uses different session service instances for browser and app windows. So for now, the idea is to mirror that transparently at platform level, rather than assuming a single session and imposing restrictions to higher level layers. Now, whilst you may not use or care about Chrome directly, never forget that most other browsers are built off of Chrome. I do make use of Flop, so I'm not. But I also use Brave. I have Chromium installed as well. But if you're using, say, Vivaldi, if you're using ungoogled Chromium, if you're using a bunch of other browsers based on Chromium. So having this here is really good for those. But also don't forget that Electron, the way that apps like Discord, Element, and a bunch of others are built, along with a bunch of other web-centric projects, are based off of Chromium. So having this in Upstream Chromium is going to affect those applications eventually as well. Now, we're still quite a while away from a world where full session restoration actually works on Wayland, but never forget that it never really worked perfectly on X11 either. People seem to forget this part. Like, a lot of applications did work fine, and yes, you could remember window positions, but full session restoration has never been something that consistently worked. It did work when we were running the X11 server and the applications on separate systems, because it was very easy to disconnect the two. But now they're running together, there's a lot more coupling between the two, and it hasn't really worked perfectly for a while. You might have cases where it does work well, but it certainly wasn't consistent. Now, the whole window placement thing is another part of this which definitely does need to actually fall in place. Being able to position windows is very important. I don't understand why there's pushback against doing this. But hey, Wayland is going to be Wayland. At least for the core part of session restorations, even if the windows don't go back to the correct position, at least that part there, better than nothing. So let me know, do you care about session restoration? If things crash, Do you just get over it? If you quit out with all your windows open, do you want them to come back? I'd love to know. If you like the video, go like the video. If you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out my Patreon, subscribe, Silly Berape, linked in the description down below. That's gonna be it for me, and restore this.